Welcome to our fourth video in the QuickBooks Personal Home Finance course, Putting in Your Accounts. You need only the names of each bank account and each credit card account. You do not have to put the account number. There would be no reason, as long as you can identify which one it is. After we open the chart of accounts, we will remove the accounts that QuickBooks put there. If we cannot delete the account, one of the accounts that QuickBooks put, we will simply make it inactive. Let's take a look at how we would do this. From the main menu, click List, Chart of Accounts. Some of these accounts you will be able to delete because they are ones that QuickBooks puts whether you like it or not. The ones that you can't delete, you can make inactive. I happen to know the two associated with payroll you will not be able to delete. So let's delete the others right now. Click on Opening Balance Equity. Then in the bottom left, click Account, Delete, and click OK, and it will disappear. Click on Retained Earnings and then click Account, Delete, and it will let you when you click OK. If you try to delete one of the other two accounts, Account, Delete, you will get a message that you're not allowed to. So instead, click Account, Make Account Inactive. That will hide it until you tell QuickBooks to show you all the accounts, active or not. Do the same thing with this one, Account, Make Inactive. Now you have a nice fresh chart of accounts. If you ever want to see all of the accounts, whether they're inactive or not, you can click this button down here and you will see that the two that we made inactive show up, but they have the X next to them. And if we remove the check mark, you will not see them. Here are the names and account types of the two bank accounts and the two credit card accounts that Joe Schmo has. Let's take a look at how to put them on the list. In the bottom left, so let's say the first one is Chase Bank and M&T Bank. So in the bottom left, click Account New. The Add New Account window opens up, and in this window, all you do is choose the type of account. In this case, bank, and QuickBooks will explain a little bit about that account type. When you click Continue, you get to the most important window, the Add New Account window. Notice bank type of account was selected from the previous window, and all you have to do is type in the name. Chase, maybe make it capitals to make it look nice. Chase Bank, and that's the name of one bank account. Notice when you click Save and New, that account has been added to the list. Don't worry about this one. This one is QuickBooks needs to add, but don't worry, it will have no effect on all your other accounts. Leave bank as the account type chosen and type in the name of your other account, M&T Bank. Then when you click Save and New, you notice M&T Bank has been added as a bank account to your list. The other two accounts are credit card accounts, Citibank Card and Capital One. So all you have to do is change account type from bank to credit card, which is down here. So now let's type Citibank Card and then click Save and New and then type Capital One. When you're finished, you don't have to click Save and New. You can click Save and Close and it will save it and close the window. Okay, this is just an advertisement to ask you for a service that QuickBooks wants to sell you. So we will just click No. Now you have both bank accounts and both credit card accounts in the chart of accounts. Now before we leave this window, let's add the chart of accounts to the icon bar so you'll never have to struggle to remember where it is if you need to open it up again. Click View, Add Chart of Accounts to the icon bar. And then when you click OK, notice here it is. So if I close this window and I click on the shortcut, here we are right back in the chart of accounts. Each account you have, that is to say each bank or each credit card account, should have a separate register window in the icon bar. Let's take a look. What you have to do is go to the main menu and click Banking, Use Register, and then choose one of the accounts that you put on the list. If you choose Chase Bank and click OK, a window opens up that looks just like the account register that your parents used to keep track of every transaction in their bank account. Notice there are two lines for every one transaction, and you would put the check number here, the person you paid would be here. You would choose which expense or income here. You would type a little memo for yourself. And if this were a check that decreased your account, you would put it in this column. However, if this transaction were a deposit, you would put it in that column. Personally, I like to view the register in an easier format. I like to click the one line box so that each transaction goes across one line. In my opinion, it's much easier to see and understand, and much easier to find what you're looking for. Now that it looks the way we need it to look, we can add it to the icon bar. Click View, Add Chase Bank to the icon bar. And then after we click OK, here's a shortcut to the register for Chase Bank. Click the shortcut, and then the register specifically for this account will open up. There's another way you can open the register window. Let's try it for the next bank account. You can click to open the chart of accounts, and instead of going to banking and opening it up that way, you can double-click directly on the account in the chart of accounts, and it will automatically open in a register window. And again, I suggest you click the one line button so that this is easy to see. The title bar will tell you which particular bank account you are recording checks or deposits into. And again, it's a good idea to have a shortcut in the icon bar. Click View, Add M&T Bank to the icon bar, then just click OK. Now when you close out all windows, you'll notice if I click here, I get the register with all my M&T transactions. If I click here, I get the Chase Bank window with all my Chase Bank transactions. Let's do it for the credit cards. Same thing. Banking, Use Register, and let's choose Capital One. When we click OK, it opens in this format where there would be two lines, or the information for each transaction is spread across two lines. I prefer clicking the check mark and having every transaction across one line so it's easier to see. To add it to the icon bar, we click View, Add Capital One to the icon bar, and click OK. Close it out. Remember, the other way to open an account in a register window is to click the chart of accounts, double-click directly on the account in the chart of accounts, and that would accomplish the same thing. You're opening the account in a register window. Again, I strongly suggest you click the one line box because, in my opinion, it's easy to see each transaction on one line rather than two. At the moment, the Citibank card register window is the active window in front. That's the moment you can click View, Add Citibank card to the icon bar, then click OK. Now you'll notice whichever one you click as a shortcut, that particular register window will open up for you to record transactions in that account. Every individual should have one bank type of account for your cash on hand, which is also the cash in your wallet if you tend to use a wallet. But it should be an account in the chart of accounts so you can keep track of your personal cash as it comes into your pocket and leaves your pocket or wallet. And it should be a bank type of account because money goes in and out of your pocket and your wallet. We will put it on the list the same exact way. Let's close these out. Open the chart of accounts. From the bottom left, click Account, New. Make sure you choose bank type of account because QuickBooks is showing you for petty cash, which is your cash on hand or in your wallet, bank type of account is appropriate. Click Continue. Make sure that bank is still chosen, and then put, I would either say cash on hand or cash in wallet. Cash on hand, and you could say wallet if you want to be more specific. Click save and close. Click no for the advertisement. Now again, you should have the wallet register in your icon bar. Double click. Click the one line as I suggest. Then click view, add cash on hand to the icon bar, and click OK. You should use this specific register, the cash on hand with wallet register, every time you withdraw cash and put it in your pocket, or every single time you pay money for a cash expense, and each of these lines that you record a transaction in should be matched to a receipt that somebody gives you.